Welcome to Understand the Math. For this question, we're asked to give a geometric description. Let's go ahead and let's highlight that. Geometric description of the span of V1, V2, and V3. And then we're given vectors V1, V2, and V3. Let's go over a little bit of theory before we go ahead and dive into the solution of this problem. What you need to know to solve this problem is that the span of V1, V2, and V3 is just a linear combination of those three vectors. And we can write that as C1, V1 plus C2, V2 plus C3, V3. In order to find the geometric description of our span, we need to determine the linear independence or dependence of our V vectors. The way that we're going to do that is we're going to take a matrix and we're going to put vectors V1, V2, and V3 in it. And then we're going to take that matrix and we're going to put it in echelon form. And then we're going to count the pivots. Let me show you how to do this. We're going to take a matrix and we're going to put our three vectors in it. So we have 1, minus 2, minus 5, 2, 5, and 6, and then 7, 4, minus 3. We need to put it in echelon form. So I'm going to start by circling our pivots. That's our first pivot. And we need to get a 0 below those pivots. Let's go ahead and let's write down the row operations that we're going to use. So we're going to take row 2, and we're going to replace it with row 2 plus 2 times row 1. And then we're going to take row 3, and we're going to replace it with row 3 plus 5 times row 1. Let's go ahead and do this. Our first row is going to stay the same. Our second row is going to become a 0. And then we're multiplying the first row by 2 and adding it to our second row. So we have a 4 plus 5 gives us a 9. And then we have a 14 plus 4 gives us an 18. Now we're going to change our third row. We're going to multiply row 1 by 5 and add it to our third row. So we get a 0. And then we have a 10 plus 6 is a 16. And then we have a 35 minus a 3 gives us a 32. Now I want you to look at rows 2 and row 3. Notice in those rows, the numbers in those rows are multiples of each other. So what I'm going to do, and I always tell my students, I call this like housekeeping. We're going to take row 2 and we're going to replace it with row 2 divided by 9. And then we're going to take row 3 and we're going to replace it with row 3 divided by 16. That's called scaling, and it's just going to make our matrix a little bit easier to work with. So we have a 1, a 2, and a 7, and then we have a 0, 1, 2, and then look at that. We have another 0, 1, 2. Whenever you have a row that's a repeat of a row, what's going to happen is that row is going to go to 0, because what we would do is we would take row 3 and we would replace it with row 3 minus row 2. So I always tell my students, whenever you see a repeated row, you can automatically know that that repeated row is going to go to 0. Let's go ahead and write that down. Our first two rows are the same. So we have 1, 2, 7, 0, 1, 2, and then 0, 0, 0. Now, what we're after is the geometric description. So that means we have to know how many vectors, V1, V2, and V3, we have to know how many of these are linearly independent. So if we circle our pivots, we can see that we have two pivots. So that means that we're going to have two linearly independent vectors. So our geometric description is going to be based on that. Let me just kind of summarize here. If you have one pivot, the geometric description is going to be a point. If you have two pivots, it's going to be a plane. And then if you have three pivots, it's going to be what we call 3D space. So our geometric description is going to be a plane in. Now we have to go back up. Notice that our vector has three entries. So that means our vectors are elements of R3. So if we go back down here, that means our geometric description is that the span of these three vectors is going to be a plane in R3. A geometric description will include what we call an object and then the Euclidean space where the vectors are located.
If this video has been helpful to you, please consider subscribing to my channel. Keep believing in yourself and have a great rest of your day.